All right. Okay. We are here with the EPS Classic. And today we are going to go through B23 of the Carpenters Sawdust. That's Wave 23. And if you don't know, the Carpenters Sawdust is a group of waveforms for your Ensoniq sampler that includes the ASR-10, the EPS 16 Plus, and of course, what we're on here today, the EPS Classic. Now, Wave 23 is described as a monophonic, partially gliding, morphing, aliasing, slightly searing, saw-like waveform. And it's harsh and aggressive. I'd say those words describe it most. Now, some user tips before we get on to hearing what it sounds like is if you engage aftertouch, it slightly engages a two-pole low-pass filter. So as you press down, let's describe first. Yeah, let's do the low-pass now. So if I just play it, press harder. Right, so it can sort of mimic tremolo or vibrato, that sort of thing if you like, but mostly just to give it a dim play. However, if you engage the mod wheel, it engages a second layer. So this is one of the waveforms that actually contains two layers. You'll find that a little bit of the waveforms sort of involve two in one. So this is a 1+1. If you engage it, you can add in that second waveform, which gives you it does a lot of things. And what I'll do is I'll describe it as I play. So let's just take a listen to how it brings in. I'll just play a C and I'll bring it in. So you heard that second waveform come in and you hear just more texture changes. However, since this is monophonic gliding, you will notice a stark difference between the bass layer and the upper layer when you play monophonically. So if I do this, you can barely hear it on the lower registers, but let's bring it up to the higher registers and we'll hear. So we'll start with the lower. Because it's partially gliding, the second waveform glides, but the first one stays steady. So let's go up a bit. Without bringing in the second waveform, it sounds like this. As we bring in the second waveform, you'll hear the glide. Right, so there's a whole lot of just playing stuff you can do to add to the music. Just with the one waveform, there's a lot of looks, as with all the waveforms here. Now, to go a little bit further, let's just place it into space and we'll do some playing and you can hear what it sounds like. We'll add a little bit of delay and a little bit of reverb. Okay, so that is the sound so far. There's a lot of playing in it, but as you can see, it's a monophonic sound, and it's got that just harshness to it where... A lot of aliasing as well. So a very versatile sound and has a lot of little playing tips and tricks in there built in. Now, if you're sort of just a little bit unfamiliar with layers, layers is what unlocks the complete sound capabilities of any Ensoniq product. There's so many things you can do by layering these sounds to come up with so much stuff. As you can see, the waveforms hold their own, but when they get layered with stuff, it's out of control. And of course, if you are in any way wanting to learn as much as you can about the Ensoniq Trilogy samplers, the ASR-10 Beginners Manual would be the thing for you as an accompanying piece to the Carpenter Sawdust. The ASR-10 Manual is also applicable to all the Trilogy samplers, EPS Classic, EPS 16 Plus as well, and it will get you completely up to speed on how to take advantage of this. Also, the free manual downloaded for each of these sounds, in case you're wondering what all the sounds are and what they do. We're on sound 23 now, but you can look at all the sounds in the manual with a full description of each to see if this is the sound set for you. However, if you have any of the Trilogy samplers and you do not have the Carpenter Sawdust as yet, what on earth are you waiting for? Info in the description box below. Head over to thedaydreamsound.com and get yourself sorted. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.